Hello and welcome to my presentation. Today I am going to talk about fast food and why should we stop eating fast food. In my presentation, there will be 5 parts: introduction and 3 reasons and the conclusion. Nowadays, fast food is considered to be one of the most threats to human beings. Being in a hurry all the time, a regular citizen may have no time for satisfying even the basic needs, such as nutrition. This is probably why fast food restaurants are crowded all the time. In the case of fast food, things are not that simple, even though the majority of people know about the dangers of eating from McDonald's, Burger King, Subway, and similar places. They still go there. The factors causing such behavior should be analyzed separately. Instead, this presentation focuses on the reasons why you should quit eating fast food as soon as possible. The most obvious reasons everyone is aware of is the increased risk of developing obesity. Sometimes being overweight is caused by health problems or psychological issues. However, becoming overweight is evoked by dysfunctional eating habits and the regular consumption of fast food. According to research, people eating fast food regularly develop much higher risks of gaining extra weight. They are also more likely to develop type 2 diabetes. Unfortunately, not only adults are exposed to these risks. Teenagers and children are also at risk. Throughout the last 30 years, the rates of teenagers' obesity have tripled. For children, this index has doubled over the same period of time. This might be related to sophisticated advertising, but facts remain facts. Fast food leads to obesity, and all age groups are at risk. Unlike the organic food, which is by default created from pure natural ingredients, fast food often has a bunch of doubtful ingredients in it. To start with, all kinds of enhancers are added to it so that it tastes and smells better. Conservatives and food preservatives are added in particular. As if this was not enough, fast food may contain the reminders of drugs and antibiotics. How do they get there? The good news is that fast food does contain real meat. The bad news is that animals are kept in such awful conditions that they suffer from several diseases. To deal with this problem, fast food manufacturer may add antibiotics to animals' nutrition. Later, they can get to your body when you eat your next chicken burger. Along with the risks of developing obesity and pumping your body with doubtful chemicals, eating fast food often means exposing almost every organ of your body to dangers. For example, it becomes easier to get kidney diseases because fast food is often salty and greasy. It increases blood pressure, makes you want to drink all kinds of soda drinks, which are unhealthy in their own way, and affects kidneys badly. Besides, due to the high amount of cholesterol content in these fast food, your cardiovascular system suffers as well. This is not to mention the fact that processed fats and fries and other junk food, when supplied to the brain instead of nutrition, affect cognitive abilities in a negative way. In particular, according to research conducted on rats, a week of daily fast food consumption caused memory loss in test subjects. And as if this was not enough, junk food increases the chances to get cancer. As it can be seen, cheap and tasty food is not what your body needs. To start with, when eating fast food regularly, you put yourself at risk of developing obesity and possibly type 2 diabetes. Some crucial organs of your body, such as kidneys, heart, and the brain, suffer from junk food. And if adverse health effects are not enough for you, think about the preservations, antibiotics, and other chemicals you stuff your body with when eating fast food. That's all for my presentation, and thanks for listening.